of the Rudy Scheidt School of Music.
And jazz singers. Coming out tonight. Isn't it beautiful? Isn't the weather beautiful for this? We're so fortunate to be able to have this group here in First Signs of Spring with the University of Memphis groups. Our jazz singers, give them a big hand. Southern Pepper Jazz Orchestra. It's a little bit different show for us. We're going to do a soul and Motown, a little bit of gospel for you. That's the way you do it in Memphis, right?
Right. Yeah.
So we put together a neat show for you to come out and do the opening part of this. Thanks. Enjoy.
Oh,
Williams on the lead vocal. And on the low part, Sir Lattimore. Of course, that's Ike and Tina Turner, and that's one of the most famous things when we talk about that era of music. The next thing we're going to do on the hit parade of that brings us forward about, that's about 20 years, I think, 18 or 20 years. But this is a Michael Jackson thing that we're going to do, and I think you're on this, Shalit, right?
I am.
Yeah, you are. So this is Man in the Mirror. Oh, I think you're on this too. Evan, both Evan and Sean are gonna do Man in the Mirror for us right now, but made famous by Michael Jackson.
Yeah.
John, Evan, take a bow, please.
It's me again, y'all.
Of course, you can't talk about 1960s, early 70s, especially Motown and Stax and any of the music from especially this part of the country in terms of the impact of Aretha Franklin. There's just no way you can do without her music, and we're honored to be able to do one of these tunes. And it's an old chart that I did of, well, you'll know the tune. She spells it out. You'll get it. Angel Williams on that, and the jazz singers. I'd be remiss not to introduce this guy. All the way on the end there is that's the other professor that helps with these groups, and I cannot do it without him. That's Alvy Gavon helping us out tonight. He's one of our own. He's one of our own graduates. Did his bachelor's and his master's with us years ago, and he's one of our professors. He's our jazz pianist. Teaches jazz piano for us and co-conducts these wonderful singers. Give them another round of applause, the jazz singers. And you need to come out on Tuesday night. We are at the Green Room, Crosstown Green Room. We're starting at 7:30, right? Yeah, we're starting at 7:30. And Professor Shoup's group is going to go first, 901 Jazz, and then you'll hear these two groups. On that concert, 7:30 at the Crosstown Green Room on Tuesday night, and I'll remind you again before the end, before we get done here, of course. So come on out, it'll be great. It'll be a whole new set of stuff. That's how good they are. We do a whole new set of things. You're hearing this tonight, and then you're gonna hear a whole new set of things with some soloists and some really neat things that we're doing from the New York Voices. So as we get on with this, I think Graceland's going to sing on this one. Yeah. This is a tune that's been done a number of times by a number of people, but I think the most famous, correct me if I'm wrong, would be Benny King. Stand By Me, right? It's the Benny King version, right? Yeah. Okay. Our expert there in the front row. Yeah. But there's a whole bunch of... But our expert, Graceland, is going to... take a whack at this, sort of, I guess. Okay, she'll sound pretty. Excellent Penn, jazz singers. Another great personality, great hit maker during that time of the 1960s was James Brown. Yeah. James Brown. We're going to kind of switch it around a little bit because the lyric works well for this. It's a man's world, but it has to have a woman in it. Has to. Very much so. So yes, has to. Yeah. So it's not really a man's world. It's. And I think Evan's going to do this for us. So.
If you're gonna fall, you see I'm gonna have to come get you. So whose world is it? It is the jail.
This way.
Vasquez. Let some of our singers go for a second. Probably the, in my eyes, the most key person in terms of the transition from jazz to R&B to Motown is probably Ray Charles, I would say. Wouldn't you say? I think he's, historically, that's the guy who I kind of trace one thing to the other. You probably didn't know this, but Ray Charles was a very good alto saxophonist as well as the keyboardist and the singer, and the pivotal way he did things historically, and the way he was discovered. And he was kind of discovered inadvertently. But one of the things that he made famous is an old blues tune. And this is probably the jazziest thing that we're going to do tonight. And it's a chart of Let the Good Times Roll. And I think we're going to let Sean Campbell handle this. And a few others are going to solo on this. I think Alex is going to blow on this. And then Becca is going to play. And I think we're going to have Asia play on this. So we've got a whole host of people that are going to play on this. So let the good times roll.
Woo!
Thank you.
Sean Campbell.
Awesome.
Let me bring the our singers back. Again, this coming Tuesday, with this group, these two groups, plus our 901 jazz group, are going to be at the Crosstown Arts Green Room. It's a great venue. We've been kind of making that our home now. It's really a nice venue, and there's a bar there. I didn't say that. So that tends to attract people, you know? I don't know. So, it's been really nice, and acoustically it's great. It's just a wonderful venue for us. So we've been having a lot of fun there, and all of these folks love to have their friends come out and see them at that place. It's a real neat club atmosphere, and it's as good as a place I've been to in New York or New Orleans or Berlin or London. It's really a great venue if you haven't been there, so you need to come out to the Crosstown Arts Green Room. Now that we have them all back here. This is a thing that we like doing that's it's a neat Bill Withers tune. I'm a real fan of Bill Withers' writing. I think his writing during the, Bill Withers fan. He wrote some great hits. I think he's a relatively, I don't want to say obscure, but he's a lesser known person, but he really, during that time of the late 60s and the early 70s, wrote some fantastic tunes. And this is a lesser known tune of his and a great chart done by a good friend of mine, Matthias Knock. I was very fortunate a couple of years ago to be writing for the Young Voices of Brandenburg in Berlin, really great jazz choir. Matthias came up with this chart on Bill Withers' Grandma's Hands. And we do it kind of in a neat way, and it's really nice to have that guy in the end doing it with us. It's really a special way we do this, Grandma's Hands. And who's featured on this? Sir Lattimore's featured on this. There we go. So, Ed Evan.
All right, now we need a little bit of crowd participation.
All right, man.
Crowd participation. We're gonna snap. We're gonna snap. All right. All right. Here we go. Thank you.
was kind of all of them, but our feature is Sir Lattimore, and I think Emily sang a little on that, and Gracelyn and Heaven sang a little bit of that. It's gone so fast. I mean, gosh. Please give all of these folks, before we do our last tune, we only got a last tune and then a thing, but please give them a big round of applause. This is the Jazz Singers of the University of Memphis. And the Southern Comfort Jazz Orchestra. Please. Let me get some music over here for a second. We've got to cap it off here. We've got a duet with Angel and Sean, and this is kind of a great anthem of that music and of that time. Is "Ain't No Mountain High Enough"?
All right, now.
All right. Great chart. Another friend of mine, Freddie Van Monsite, did the chart on this. But again, please come out, and if you liked tonight, and I hope you did, come out on Tuesday night to the Green Room. And you'll hear these folks do a whole new set of music. So they've worked very hard the past few weeks to put together two shows. I'm going to say this because I'm going to brag about them, is that a lot of these singers and these instrumentalists last night, because of the storm that got canceled, that they were putting together a show that we had at the Bluff also. So folks, I mean, we've got some great performers at the University of Memphis. It's a top flight school of music. It really is.
Woo!
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. They deserve it. They deserve it. And we hope to see you. And I'll say one more thing before this is that we are moving into a new $44 million building in fall. We're very proud of that.
Woo!
And we're very excited at the future that we have in there. Big new 1,000-seat hall, and we've got some great rehearsal rooms and settings and so on. So we're very excited. It's overdue. I've been around here for a while, and it's nice to see. So, but let's get on with it. And ain't no mountain high enough. And let's hear this duet with these two folks.